check this out. That's what we're dealing with. Jesus. This is Newark. Population 281,944. Settled in 1666 by those of the New Haven colony, Newark is one of the oldest still remaining European cities in the United States. During its early days, Newark saw a large amount of population and industrial growth, mostly through the 19th century. But by the 20th century, things began to go downhill. After many, many depressions and economic losses, the city itself began to fall apart. As a result of these economic crashes, some of its most historic buildings have been left to rot, as the city does not have money to renovate or repair these, not even the money to tear them down. Today we'll be focusing on one of these specific buildings, this building being the Essex County Jail. At its peak, Essex County Jail could hold a captivity of 300 people after being extended in the 90s. But as of 2001, it was deemed unsafe and closed permanently. Unfortunately though, this did not deter people from deciding to live there. Heroin addicts run rampant in Essex County Jail. As you will see, there are many personal items, children's toys, and other belongings spread about the area, which caused us to be on a great level of alert. To top this off, there are many used drug paraphernalia, such as needles, pipes, and other things spread about, and no one to account for these things. It's almost like entering someone's home, but it feels wrong. Guess that would be the difference. This place is basically ruins at this point.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh god.
Alright.
Yeah. So far we've already found some bags and things that belong to people that are currently living here. As you can see, it is in total an absolute wreck. Let's see what we can find. At this point, all we had found so far was pretty much the ruins of what was the jail. So keep in mind, while these clips are moving very slow, that is simply us being cautious, as the ground was literally unrecognizable.
Let's
try this way. Jesus, this isn't even a place anymore. That's totally collapsed. There's a doorway. I don't know if it leads to anything now. Is that a toothbrush? Hopefully these floors hold. Oh damn. Yeah, now you can see these, if these were the cells, you can't see, but they were tiny.
Oh yeah.
Absolutely small as can be. Yeah.
Even
I know. I don't trust anything right now. Everything's just stuff left everywhere. That looks like the actual rest of the building over there might still be a little bit more intact. I think, yeah, there's an entrance right there. Yeah, right there. Let's try to get in. This path is treacherous to get in here. Oh, dude, watch out. That's a giant asshole. Hey. Hole. Big asshole. Hey, God.
Oh, my God.
Dude. No way.
Aaron, Al.
Dude, it's huge. Oh my God, it's beautiful. I mean, not really, but. Dude. My God, is this cool. Check this out. That's what we're dealing with. Jesus. It's massive. Apparently, people with drug addictions end up staying here. And they sleep in the cells. If you ask me, it's almost ironic, but not quite. Everything really is in bits and pieces. The second floor now.
I'm coming over to you now.
Look at the collapse. This place is legitimately in pieces.
I'm gonna walk by you. No, do not do that. These floors aren't really that stable, so I'm gonna come down to you.
And Austin was right. We quickly realized that most of the flooring in this place was collapsing in. And if we didn't watch our step, something bad was bound to happen. And fast. Talking already? That's weird.
Where are you at?
We're over here. Watch out, there's a lot of nails and shit. God, if that's not creepy.
Oh, Alex, look at this shit.
I know, dude. Darker parts of the building first, I guess. Some of it's still kind of structurally intact, but not much. Just to give you an idea.
Holy shit, man.
Empty corridors. Oh, there's another big piece. Look at that old ass chair. This is when things started getting weird. Level. This dude. What the hell? There's candles. All the candles. On the ground too. Bunches of candles. What is going on in here? What are people doing in here? There's never been an exploration that felt more scary. People were practically living out of these. Maybe still are. I smell nothing. Literally nothing, dude.
Somebody's laughing. Whoa.
What?
Was that you that just grabbed me? Dude, something just pulled my backpack.
Jesus. Well, I'm not much of a ghost believer. This next room, the minute I walked in, the air had a stillness that was not seen anywhere else in the building, and it only lasted for a brief few moments. It's... Dude, come in here. Does it feel different in here to you?
Oh,
Walk in.
Whoa.
Tell me you feel that, right? I'm not a ghost believer, but dude, I feel that. It feels...
Hold on.
It feels so different in here.
I
what was this?
Indeed we are, and something is following us and grabbing me, man.
I guess this was where they discharged. Maybe some form of an entryway. These are some old stairs. Very old stairs.
Alright, hold on. Give me like 30 seconds?
Yeah, take your time. We'll look around a little bit.
Alright.
Supposed to be like the courtyard between the buildings. What the hell is going on in this place? It feels wrong. That's coming from me. What is in this room? What the hell? Okay, look in there, you'll see. This was like a classroom. This is an old classroom. Postcard. Man, this is weird. Ceiling's decaying, starting to collapse in. Typical though. What happened?
If that was you, can you say that again? Please say that again. I don't feel
it. Hold on, man. I'm taking this out. There's a bunch of old chairs. All right. What the hell? Come on. Flashlight just broke. That's different. Now, what you're going to see next is when we really start running into the personal items that we found earlier. It's very important to note that some of these things looked very recent, some looked like they'd been there for a very long time, but all in all, it was just kind of disturbing to see how well some of them were actually set up and how much effort people had actually put into calling this home. In a great way, it was very saddening. One thing that stuck with me throughout all of this the most, which you're going to see in a moment, is when we reached the third floor of the cell block, we saw the most elaborate and well put together makeshift home of the entire area. But the thing that got to me was having to see that there were children's toys, and a lot of them placed all throughout the block. A little girl was living there with her parents. I wonder what life was like for her. I wonder if that's still her life now. Why is there a kid's stroller in here? Shit. What's up? I know. Dude, there's a stroller in that one. Why do they hang their clothes in there? It's just such a freaky thing. Like, just why? Man. Let's try to get up the rest of these stairs. Look at these cells. Alright, someone was definitely squatting in here.
What?
So, oh, dude. These get detailed. They even have chairs and shit. Holding all their stuff. This looks like it got burned to pieces in here. Whatever was in there.
Oh, there was a fire in 2012.
What the fuck?
There's that fucking heart thing again.
Look, there's a book. What the fuck? That's Arabic. That's Arabic. It's a heart candle. This newspaper is in Arabic. No, it's in English. What the fuck is all this? There's DVDs. I don't want to know. Better off not knowing. I don't need to know what you're hanging. Gloves, clothing, who is here? More clothes. Bottles, a bunch more clothes. It's like people started to try to set up padding and shit all over the floor so they could live here better.
Oh, that's creepy.
Yeah, not exactly my favorite. Is there really cell phone cases? Man, it's just like someone's junk drawer their entire life.
Oh my god.
What the fuck is going on? Hello? Hello? Hey, walk along the outside of the cell block. Fuck that. Maybe we should just leave this floor alone. Does it seem stable? What the fuck? Dude, someone's fully living up here. This isn't even squatting at this point. This is like someone's living here. Kids' toys. It's so sad. Each fucking cell's been converted into something. What is that? Cough drops. Little kids' playhouse. More beer cans. If you see anything really suspicious. Not to mention the fucking flooring we're walking on right now. What?
I found his bathroom.
How do you know? Wow.
That's how I know.
I guess that makes it obvious. Don't be alarmed. That was not an intended pun.
All feelings. Nothing like the King's Park.
Dude.
Ow.
You
alright? Yeah, I just hit my hand.
That's not something
here,
glass thing
over
there.
Yep.
Hey, not too much rain in here at once, man. These are floors made of fucking glass. They're just glass floors. Just a squirrel.
Is there really anything in there?
So far now. Just really depressing. After this, not really much else happened. We went down to the basement, found a respirator from what we could only assume was another explorer who for some reason left it there. Look what we just found. That would be a fellow explorer. Well, why did they run away? And leave the respirator. And we went home. It was a dark place, but it was our time to go. Oh, you can take this video for whatever you decide to take it as. But I would like to note that while we were in Newark, there was a lot of people that did still hold some hope for that city. In fact, anyone that we asked to try to be of the film seemed extremely enthused to let us into anywhere we wanted to, and were just trying to help us get clearance. Because they still believed in that city, and they wanted to see something come out of that city that could maybe help those people. So even though it may look sad, remember, there is always hope, even in the dark places. I'll see you guys in the next video.
Anything goes. When Mrs. Ned McLean, God bless her, can get Russian red to yes, then I suppose anything goes. When Rockefeller still can hoard enough money to let Max Gordon produce his show.